Let me tell you how miserable my mornings are without breakfast. I hate everyone. Yes, everyone. Even that old lady who took the last seat on the train. I hate you. Hey guys, Julia here for DNews. Do we need breakfast? I mean, your mom always tells you you need to eat it, but do you really need to? A recent study published in the Journal of Public Economics says yes. The researchers found that schools that provided free breakfast for their students had better test scores than those that didn't. The kids performed 25% better in math and had similar gains in other areas like reading. But this news isn't entirely new. Breakfast is often heralded as the most important meal of the day, and science backs this up. There are loads of studies that show just how important it is for learning and memory, but it might not have the weight loss benefits you think. Anyways, is it breakfast that helps give your brain a boost, or is it the type of food you eat? I mean, the brain consumes a lot of energy. Almost 20% of the energy we consume goes to the brain. Some researchers say that the brain functions best when there's 25 grams of glucose circulating through the bloodstream. So really, you should keep that as level as possible. Any spike or dip can leave you feeling off. So maybe eating more frequent, smaller meals throughout the day can help you avoid a post-lunch crash. But is there a way to hack your brain with food? Is there such a thing as brain food? I mean, I was always told to eat a banana before a test. Curcumin and omega-3 seem to be buzzing around the blogosphere of late, and that may have some truth to it. According to a paper published in the National Review of Neuroscience, these nutrients lessen cognitive decline in the elderly and improve cognition in people with brain injuries. Your typical sources of omega-3 are in fish, like salmon, and in other things like flax seeds and walnuts. Curcumin can be found mostly in turmeric, a type of spice. Other nutrients like iron and B vitamins help memory and brain function in women, while diets high in saturated fats tend to do the opposite. Omega-3s and other micronutrients might be the heavy hitters of brain food. One study published in the American Journal of Clinical Nutrition found that a cocktail of omega-3s, iron, zinc, folate, and vitamins A, B6, B12, and C helped kids in Australia and Indonesia do better on learning and memory tests. Another study published in the journal Appetite by some of the same researchers found that foods low on the glycemic index are better for breakfast. The glycemic index rates food based on how it affects your glucose levels or level of sugar. The study found that yes, kids' memory and cognitive function do decline throughout the morning, but a low GI breakfast reduced that decline more than a breakfast with a high GI. Low GI foods are like fruits and vegetables or maybe even oatmeal. So a good breakfast might be a bowl of oatmeal with a banana rather than a bowl of sugary cereal. So a balanced diet with fish and fruits and veggies seems to be good for the brain. Eating breakfast might keep you perkier in the morning, so you're more alert to learn more. And some studies even show that old wives' tale of chewing gum for a test is true. Chewing gum increases blood flow to the brain, which does all sorts of good things. So before a big test, eat a good breakfast, no not sugary cereals, and maybe have a piece of gum. What is your go-to test food? Let us know in the comments below, and while you're at it, hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back here. We've got new episodes every day of the week.